It's a cold night here in Ames, but it's scorching hot indoors here at Hilton Coliseum. The three most important partially hyphenated words in the state of Iowa when it comes to gymnastics, Cy Hawk Meet. And for the 88th time, it is the Iowa State Cyclones taking on the Iowa Hawkeyes. Welcome, everybody, to Hilton Coliseum. Alex Cohen, joined here by All-American Andrea Maldonado. You've done this before, the Cy Hawk Meet. First, let's talk about the Iowa Hawkeyes. Karina Munoz, a sophomore, she's been stellar in the all-around, expected to be stellar tonight.
Karina Munoz, a sophomore that has run consistently to score nine nines on both the beam and the floor, while also being a rock for the Hawkeyes on the all-around event.
She is pumped there doing the all-around event. And now let's go to Iowa State. Not only is it the Cy Hawk Meet, it's also senior night. One of those seniors, Kaya Parker, she is primed for a big night, especially on the floor.
Kaya Parker has taken the leadership role within her senior year, which has led her to score her second 9925 on the floor event. This is not only senior night, but again, the Cy Hawk series, which makes this night so special for both teams.
It is going to be a special night. I'm pumped, I'm excited. We are going to take a break. When we come back, it's rotation one. It's the Cy Hawk Meet. It's Iowa State in Iowa. And it all comes up next right here on ESPN+. Back here on Big 12 Now on ESPN+, Alex Cohen and Andrea Maldonado, former All-American for the Iowa State Cyclones. Again, here from Hilton, it is the Cy Hawk Series, Iowa State and Iowa. It is the 88th meeting between the two programs. And Iowa State leads this series 54-33, last meeting March 4, 2023. Andrea, yeah, my first gymnastics meet for Iowa State, I was on the call 2022. You were a senior in this. You know, you look at the stands, you see everybody here, you see all the smiles, see all the enthusiasm. It brings you back a little bit. Yeah, how big is this meet for both programs?
I think this is a very special night for both programs. You know, this rivalry has a lot of history back, you know, behind it. There's a lot of, I want to say, like,
you're excited right now just talking about
it. Yes, it's like very fierce, very passionate. I think both teams get very excited to go about this meet. It does heighten a lot of pressure, which can be detrimental for, you know, those small details. But it should be a really close meet because these both teams are doing amazing this season.
Cyclones last scored the Hawkeyes on March 1st, 2019. Last time these two programs played each other here at Hilton Coliseum was 2022. About to get started. It is now time for our starting lineups. And we'll start with the Iowa State vault. Paige Wills, the freshman, Hadaloyam, a junior, Kaya Parker, we talked about in the open. One of the seniors here honored on senior night, Noelle Adams, three-time newcomer of the week. Freshman joined by Josie Bergstrom and Emily Hong, the senior. Next up, it'll be, I believe, the bars for Iowa. We'll talk about that in a second. The first here is Paige Wills. Season high, a 9.85. She's done it twice on the vault. And that's a nice start.
That is a really good start for the Cyclones right there. They're going to want to really focus on those, you know, good landings. It's going to come down to the small details. I think they have what it takes to just give Iowa a run for their money.
It's a nice start by the freshman from Kimberton, Pennsylvania. Now another underclassman, Gianna Masella. Actually, it's Kaya Vanni. Get things started for the bars.
So far, a really good routine. She's taking her time, making sure those handstands are right at the vertical, getting ready for her dismount, and that is an almost stuck landing for the Hawkeyes, just like it was for the Cyclones.
Well, that's quite a start here at Hilton Coliseum. Two competitors, two sound routines. And here's Hadaloyam, one of the seniors here honored on senior night. Hadaloyam has been an all-around gymnast for the majority of her senior campaign.
Hannah has had a spectacular year growing into her junior year here with a Drochenko full. Really good landing for that vault. You can see she's very happy with that.
Highest mark of the ball was a 9.825 against Penn State back in January. Yeah, her sister Emma was a gymnast at Boise State. I said Loyan was a senior. She's actually a junior. But again, in her campaigns here with Iowa State, she's gotten a lot of experience, yeah, especially on the vault.
That's right. Coming up for our, even on her freshman year, looking back at that, she had a lot of exposure. She was a very reliable athlete for this team.
I mean, it's interesting. I mean, you were teammates with some of these gymnasts. How's it feel to be on the other side of this right now?
It's very gratifying to see them grow and certainly put out their best work. It makes me really proud of them.
Love that. Ilka Juck, a 9.875 last week on the bars at Sacramento State. There is a lot of momentum here for both programs. You can feel the energy at Hilton Coliseum.
You can tell she was trying to get that stick. All throughout her routine, she was like taking deep breaths, pacing herself. And I think this bar lineup is going to be like that all through and through. Kaya Parker, beautiful full. Again with a little hop. I'm sorry for interrupting you.
No, yeah. You're good. Keep going. Talk gymnastics to me.
She usually has this like very big flare out of her full. You can see it here a little bit where she like opens up really big and is able to find that landing. Today she had a little bit too much power, but again, so beautifully done.
Her season high, a 9.85 on vault. She's done it twice. Career high last year, a 9.875.
Mind you, a 9.875 coming from a vault that starts from a 9.95, not a 10.0. That means that she had minimal deductions in that execution.
So we have some scores. So it looks like Hannah Loyum, a 9.75. Paige Willis, a 9.775. And then Kaya Vanney on the bars for Iowa, a 9.725.
I say we're looking pretty even here.
And you talked about it in the open. You have two programs that, in the national rankings, they're separated by one. I mean, the margin for error in any Cy-Hawk meet is so small, but especially right now with two evenly matched programs.
Correct.
And in the middle of rotation one, Iowa on the bars, Iowa State on the vaults.
That's a first stuck landing for the Hawkeyes. I'm sorry. We can see here her release. Beautiful execution right there. Then her dismount.
That was Eva Volpe. Right back at it. This is a quick pace. Noelle Adams, a freshman.
Noelle has been so confident throughout this entire year. It gives me shivers to even look at her and how she, you know, goes about her gymnastics. It's very interesting to see how she's so comfortable.
Well, I mean, she's a freshman, and you see, I think the one word to describe it is poise. She is poise.
Right. And she takes advantage of it every time she comes out on the floor, and I think that's what's going to make her an even better gymnast out in the future.
Seven scores on the vault for Noelle Adams of 9.85 and higher. If Kaya Parker scores, she has a 9.8 in the vault. So 9.775, 9.75, and a 9.8 for the Cyclones to start things off. Tell you what, with everything and the energy here, those are two, make that three, pretty good scores to start things off.
I agree. Masella here, she's going to show us this really beautiful bar routine we've seen a couple years before. Huge height on that Jaeger. She goes out onto her shoot over. Again, really focusing on those details. You can see how her legs just get glued together every time she has a chance. Getting ready for her dismount. Another double layout with a stuck landing. I'm telling you.
They're amped on
for the game.
She's amped. From the state of Florida, reintroducing herself to the Cy-Hawk rivalry. That's a great start. Here's Josie Bergstrom, junior from Iowa.
Josie does it again. Josie is known for this excitingly consistent vault. probably, I would dare to say, 5 out of 10 times, or even higher, 5 out of 8 times, she'll stick this landing, no questions asked.
Will you take a look at the replay there?
Mm-hmm. She had a little bit of a, you know, a little bit of a balance check there, but she was just trying to make sure she did not move. I think that will be a small deduction for how far down her chest was. But again, very, very good execution.
Well, she has the Iowa State season high in the vault, a 9.925 that came against Boise State. Mm-hmm. Again, Josie, she's been a fixture in this Iowa State program for a number of years. So it's Karina Munoz.
And we see that very interesting mount right there. A hop to a blind change. Then her Jaeger was very consistent, very pretty. She has a really fast pace in this routine. Again, but so confident on those handstands.
Wow.
Straight into her double layout. Into a little bit of a hop. You can tell she's, I would say, she reminds me of Noelle. She's very confident, very poised.
That was pretty impressive.
Yeah.
So here's the senior, Emily Hong.
Emily's going to show us the lone 10-0 vault tonight. 1.5, 2, an amazing landing for Emily. We love to see a 1.5 to take a little bit of a hop forward. That's less of a deduction when you hop for a lack of rotation.
Senior from Langley, British Columbia. Won the 2019 Canadian national title with a perfect 10. Season high, a 9.875 at NC State last week. Again, yeah, we were talking with both coaches, but referring to Emily Hong, it's senior night, and she's going to be amped. She's also going to be on the floor routine where a lot of emotions are likely to come
out.
Yeah,
here on the replay, you could see she is getting already so teary-eyed.
Wouldn't you? I mean, you've been in this spot before.
100%. I did not get myself to cry, to be honest. I was too excited to even... I cried like 2 weeks later. But yeah, it's this... Again, it's a very special night.
Here's Marissa Rojas.
Marissa's going to show us a very unique routine, starting with a toe on to a ginger. Ready for her shoot over. Getting a little bit wobbly on those transitions there. But again, maintaining such good hold of the pressure. Two white full in. Unfortunately, she had a little bit of a mishap there. I've always been a fan of double layouts because full ins can be very, like a double-edged sword. If you don't have enough rotation on your double back, you're going to land short on that dismount.
Just to recap some scores, Noelle Adams a 9.825 on the vault, Josie Bergstrom a 9.85, Emily Hong in her last vault, the Cyhawk Classic a 9.85, giving Iowa State a score of 49-1. And now looking at Iowa on the bars, recapping the scores, Volpe a 9.85, Masella a 9.85, Munoz a 9.825, and then we're looking at Marissa Rojas with their mishap, what that score will be. But you know, in your opinion, rotation one, how did it match up to you for these two programs coming against each other?
I think the worst part of a competition is definitely beam for both events, which is the third rotation, and then you have the first rotation, which you have all the jitters, all the adrenaline just rushing through your body. You just want to get started, get that pace going. So it doesn't really surprise me that all these scores are so close together. I will say Roja's score will be dropped because you have an average of the best 5 scores of each lineup. 6 girls go up and then 1 score gets dropped. And we're about to see here an exhibition routine, which also, as we approach postseason, it's very important for both teams to have options. And that's why they bring forward exhibitions and extra routines, so it makes the lineup that much more competitive.
Well, it's repetition. It's repetition as well, and being in front of, you know, a packed first level here at Hilton Coliseum, see if you can go through a routine, work it, you know, to the point where you're not making any mistakes. You're doing it in front of a bunch of people. You know, practice makes perfect.
And I think this situation for this athlete here is very crucial for her spot on this lineup because she's coming to the event after a fall. So that could also, in a real situation where she's in the lineup, can enhance the pressure for her and her scoring.
So I'm looking at the scores right now. Looks like for the vault, scores for Wills, Parker, Adams, Bergstrom, and Hong will count towards that final total. It's Hannah Williams, 9.75 will be dropped. Rojas with an 8.925, that'll be dropped. But
correct.
Vanny, Juck, Volpe, Masella, and Munoz, those scores were count. A 48.975 on the bars for Iowa and a 49.1 for Iowa State on the vault. We are going to send it down to Lily Prohaska with Iowa head coach Larissa Libby.
I'm here with head coach Larissa Libby. Coach, how do you feel about your team's performance during the first rotation?
Pretty good. There's some things that we've been talking about in practices, just going after handstands, trying to work on dismounts, the details that make the difference in the end. So most of it I felt pretty good about. We've had a heck of a cycle of competition over the last little while, so we trained once this week. So it's been rough. So I feel pretty good about what they did, and we just have to be able to drop that and then move on to the next one.
How do you feel going into vault?
We're going with five on vault, so I would love to say I feel great. The ones that we're using on vault, they've gone all season long, but we've got some little injuries here and there that we got to rest. And so, it's always a little scary when you go with five, but I have full confidence in the other ones, and it should be great.
Thanks, Coach.
Yeah, thanks.
Back here at Hilton Coliseum, we are doing the Macarena. Alex Cohen, Andrea Maldonado, and there's Noelle Adams. Rotation one, Josie Bergstrom on the vault, a 9.85, and Emily Hong on her last vault, her senior campaign. That's a 9.85 as well. Great start for the Cyclones. Now looking at Iowa on the bars, Eva Volpe, a 9.85. Gianna Masello, one of her best bars routines of the 2023-2024 campaign. And then Karina Munoz, who's been stellar all season long, a 9.825. Scores, Paige Wills, 9.775. Hannah Loimer scored drop with a 9.75. Kaya Parker, a 9.8. And we talked about the last three. Noelle Adams, a 9.825. Josie Bergstrom, a 9.85. And Emily Hong, a 9.85 as well. As we are getting into rotation two, right here at Hilton Coliseum, Iowa, the bars, Kaya Vanny, a 9.725. Ilka Juck, a 9.725. Eva Volpe, 9.85. Gianna Masella, 9.85. And Karina Munoz, beyond the all around, a 9.825. Again here, rotation two. We have Iowa State on the bars. We have Iowa on the vaults. See Gianna Masella, Avery Chambers getting things started for Iowa. Eva Volpe, the freshman. Karina Munoz, a sophomore. Elise Karen Bauer. But you look at that vault, the six gymnasts for the vault. You have sophomore, freshman, a lot of underclassmen. Now you look at Iowa State on the bars. Junior and Hannah Loyam, Paige Wills, Ella Shell, a freshman. And then three seniors. Mm-hmm. So three seniors on senior night, their last bar routine here at Hilton Coliseum.
And I also think that not only is their senior night, so they are given the benefit of the doubt in this lineup, but they have earned this place here. All three seniors have worked really, really hard for their place in the bar lineup, and it'll be a challenge for all three of them to keep their emotions together.
So again, on the bars here for the Cyclones, Loyam, Wills, Shell, Boswell, Cook, and Thomas. Should be a lot of fun here. You're looking at two really evenly matched scores on the vault. Here's Iowa. And there's a nice job by Gianna Masella.
Again, starting with a 9.95 star value vault. They had pretty similar landings at the ones that had the Cyclones before on their first vault. So having a little hop is going to give them, those deductions are very important. They're going to want to stick vaults after vaults.
Adeloyam Jr. from Mountain Lakes, New Jersey.
I want you to observe this routine.
I am.
Uh-huh.
Eyes are open.
She's very, very confident in this bar routine. She's worked so hard. Even as a freshman, again, looking back at her career so far, she's always been such a hard worker in this event. And if we can pull off a stick tonight, this will be a night to remember.
She started off as a freshman 2022 with a 9.8 against Auburn. Season high this year, a 9.875. It's a combination of fluidity, excitement, experience.
Overall, so much poise. She landed a little bit short on that Jaeger, but still so good. She's managing the pressure very well, making sure those handstands are controlled. She's getting ready for her dismount here, which is going to be a beautiful double layout. And hopefully, she makes it happen and sticks it. There she goes. Got a little bit of a hop, but that overall, such a good routine for her.
Nice job for Hannah Loy. We have a score. Gianna Masella, a 9.75 to start things off for the vault for Iowa. And now here's Avery Chambers.
Chambers with another 9.95 vault. I guess it's really interesting how both teams are putting up really, really clean and simple skills out. You can see how she takes off of the vault here and just is a little bit over-rotated and has to take a rather bigger hop backwards, but again, so clean in the air, so poised and so explosive. I don't know, I'm really excited about this.
You were talking about it's just a slightly conservative approach. Obviously, it's rotation two in the Cy-Hawk meet, but you're seeing both programs on the ball very concerned with sticking their landings and no mishaps.
Yeah, I think they have shifted their tone towards being on the more secure side rather than the aggressive side.
I think you would want to do that anyway. Yeah, no, I think that's a really good piece of information right there, and something that you picked up here on rotation too, because I would agree, and you're the gymnast and I'm not. So here's Paige Wills.
Paige has had an amazing debut her freshman year in this event. Coach Greig talks very highly of her bars since day one, so.
9.825, three times this year.
Getting ready for her double layout.
That's pretty good. That's pretty good.
Again, both teams have had that step forward or that hop, so I think they're keeping each other, on their toes. And I'm just excited to see who's going to bring out the claws first.
Alex Cohen, Andrea Maldonado. Here from Hilton Coliseum, here's Eva Volpe.
Ah, there it is, Eva with her second stick of the night.
She's just a freshman. She had a 9.85 in the bars and likely in the 9.8s when it comes to the vault.
Mm-hmm. I would agree that this would be a very well-scored vault. She had no mistakes, no hesitation. She stuck that cold. So she should get rewarded for that, I will say.
So she was the third participant in the vault for Iowa. Gianna Masella, 9.75. Avery Chambers, a 9.775. And for Iowa State on the bars, Hannah Loyan with a 9.7. Still waiting for Paige Wills' score. Now we have a freshman, Ella Schell. Her bars average this year, a 9.73. Career high, a 9.825. You have back-to-back freshmen here for Iowa State. Welcome to Iowa State right now.
I know. I was saying before this that it's impressive how many sophomores and freshmen the Hawkeyes have. But you can see they're all showing off tonight. And Ella is having no issues with this routine so far. Her legs are glued together. She's very confident. Again, very fast-paced routine. Going in for a double tuck. To a very good landing. I think she is very much of a perfectionist, so you can tell on her face when she's not very happy about something. But again, I think she should be really proud of her work.
Said Eva Volpe would be in the 9-8s. It was a 9-8-2-5. Here's Karina Munoz, and that's a nice finish on the vault.
Yeah, I think Karina is, again, very confident. And you can see here whenever we play the replay, look at how she takes off. She has so much space for even a 1.5. I mean, I hope she grows into a higher score vault.
I mean, there's just so much explosiveness when it comes to Karina Munoz. And you were talking about her in the open, the performance that she had at Sacramento State last week. And she's going to be a face and, you know, somebody this program is going to rely on for quite some time.
That's right. I mean, being a sophomore and being this important in a team so early on will only tell you that she'll continue to be a rock for this team till the end of her career at Iowa.
Here's Logan Boswell, a senior from Torrance, California. Season high 9.875 at West Virginia. Her career high 2021 a 9.9. Her average, I mean, she's pretty solid with a 9.79, right around the 9.8s. And once again, her last bars routine of, well, here at Hilton Coliseum in her collegiate career.
I think this is, you could tell in her face, she's a little bit like, oh my gosh, I'm trying to soak it all in. But yeah, I think we might see Logan also on beam. I believe in the interview with Coach Grieg, she had mentioned that there was space for Logan to also be in the balance beam, which would be a debut this season. I believe Logan hasn't been on the event the entirety of the 2023-2024 campaign, which, again, can bring a lot of nerves to the table, but she excels in both events. She has a lot of poise, a lot of grace. Her lines are very pretty. So it looks like we're only waiting for the judges to score Ella.
Yep. Karina Munoz with a 9.85. So if you look at Iowa, yeah, pretty solid here on the vault so far. 9.75, 9.775, 9.825, and a 9.85.
I think they're starting to pick up. I think they're done studying each other. And like I said before, claws are going to come out soon.
Starting to get that time of the meet where you're right in the middle of rotation number two.
Yeah, like game time, like the core of game time.
Now,
is right
I'll
here.
I'll ask you. Now, when did you feel, especially at a meet like this, now the blood's really starting to pump. Now we're starting to get our competitive edge. Is it after rotation two? Is it right at rotation three? Here's Logan Boswell, or is it right about now?
Right about now, I would say. Logan's starting with a ginormous Jaeger. There she goes, no problems. Super pretty on those handstands.
Cyclones need a big performance from Boswell here. There are three scores here on the bars. Ella Schell, the highest, with a 9.725.
And she delivers! She delivers! Like a senior would, a fifth-year senior. She delivers, and she is going to remember this forever. Look at that dismount. Very, very pretty.
That was Elise Karenbauer. Fifth gymnast on the vault. Take a look at the replay coming up shortly as her Hawkeye teammates very excited.
Yeah, she had a really good execution here. Again, very impressed that the Hawkeyes don't have a 10-0 vault. I mean, I might be wrong, but this is only the fifth gymnast, and I see them getting ready to rotate. So I'm assuming they're going to go with all five scores that they posted.
And all five are solid, no mistakes. And Logan Boswell right now is very animated, very excited. I think they have her score. He has yet to get posted yet.
I believe this is going to be a huge score for Logan.
Well, remember, her career high is a 9.9.
Oh, I see tears over there in the background.
Season high, a 9.875. We'll wait to see that score. Here's Laura Cook. Her season high last week at North Carolina State, a 9.875 senior in kinesiology and exercise science.
We're about to see the height of this routine right here, the peak of her routine. It's her dismount, and she lands that senior stick. I will say she had a micro hop, but let's be real.
That's impressive.
Yeah, in her eyes, this is perfect. This is the routine she wants on her senior year.
All right, I'm going to interrupt you. How about the score for Logan Boswell, the senior towards California? Her career high coming into tonight, a 9.9. And what does she score tonight? A 9.925. That's how you cap off your career here at Hilton Coliseum for the senior. Wow.
That is so amazing. I mean, I would be crying also, I believe, over there when they first flashed the scores. They all just bursted into tears and excitement and jumps. Oh, man, this is such a great night.
A 9.925, wow.
Amazing.
Elise Karen Bauer on the vault, a 9.825 for Iowa. So we do have Iowa's final scores, five gymnasts, count all five of them, a 9.75, a 9.775, a 9.825, a 9.85, and a 9.825. So all pretty solid scores for the Hawkeyes, and waiting for the last gymnast on the bars here for the Cyclones. It's Lauren Thomas, the senior from Loveland, Colorado. Her average, a 9.75, career high 9.9. That was against BYU in January. See how the three seniors can finish things off here for the Cyclones.
Lauren has been in this situation before anchoring for the Cyclones on the bars, so she should have no issues doing this routine. The trick is going to be into pacing herself and wanting to maintain those lines above the vertical line.
Just needs to score over a 9.65 for her score to count.
Dismount right here. Very, very good routine for Lauren. Oh, man. What a night. So far, so great.
So far, so good. So Lauren Thomas, once again, the senior in her finer Bowers routine here at Hilton. Give me your thoughts, Andrea.
I think this is amazing. My technical thoughts is that both teams are getting very well prepared for the postseason. What matters right now is not only the rivalry between these two teams and programs, but how well they're going to face each other again in the postseason. Because regionals is coming up.
Yep.
You know, after Big 12s, the real game begins. How long will these teams hold each other's, you know, tail, and who's going to make it to further than regionals?
Well, they're holding themselves accountable here tonight, where obviously it's not the main event, but when it comes to the Cyhawk meet, see what happens. Just got done rotation two here at Hilton Coliseum. We'll take a break. When we come back, we'll recap rotation two. Start rotation three of Big 12 Now on ESPN Plus. Back here at Hilton Coliseum, Alex Cohen, Andrea Maldonado just got done with rotation two. Before we recap the score, start rotation three. Let's send it down to Lily Prohaska, our sideline reporter, with first-year head coach for Iowa State, Ashley Grieg.
I'm here with Coach Ashley Miles Grieg. Coach, how are you feeling about your team's performance during the first two rotations?
I'm feeling at this point, at the halfway point, like really good with where we're at. It's really a details game at this point in the season, like getting those handstands on bars and finding the sticks. Beam is an event where we're really strong. And I just have to say, like, how about Cyclone Nation showing up for us tonight? This crowd is crazy.
How are you feeling about the senior night tonight? What would you describe the seniors?
Just as a special group, right? Like, they have been here for a while, so they've experienced everything. With the change in coaching staff and a new culture and new standards, expectations, they've jumped on board, and you're seeing that tonight. This is going to be a special night for them.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
Thanks so much, guys. Taking a look at the second rotation highlights first from the Iowa vaults. There's Eva Volpe with a 9.825. Karina Munoz, a 9.85. And then there's Elise Karen Bauer, a 9.825. Total vault score of a 49.025. We have Laura Cook and Lauren Thomas on the bars, two seniors with a 9.8 and a 9.75 respectively. And we're going to start talking about Logan Boswell. What a performance, a 9.925 in her final Cyhawk bar routine, and you can't script it much better than that.
That made me emotional. I mean, you can see the girls getting emotional with her, but that made me really emotional because she's worked so hard for this bar routine, and it's about time that the judges really start rewarding her for it. Speaking of, we are tied.
All
at
tied
an
up.
Even 98. You tell me, this is a Sci-Hawk series.
It is.
It is so amazing.
You're looking at the Iowa Hawkeyes vault scores. Again, they only had five gymnasts. No lowest score dropped. So 9.75, 9.775, 9.825, a 9.85, and a 9.825. We'll take a look at the Cyclone score on the bars. Paige Wills, her score drop with a 9.65. Hannah Loyne with a 9.7. Lachelle, the freshman, with a 9.725. Lauren Thomas, senior, with a 9.75. Laura Cook with a solid 9.8. And then Logan Boswell with a 9.925. Taking a look at rotation three on the beam for the Cyclones, Hannah Loyam. Start things off, Rachel Wilk, Noelle Adams, Josie Bergstrom, and Lauren Thomas. We forgot about Lauren Obrachta, freshman from Lamont, Illinois.
I'm very excited for this lineup.
Now for the Hawkeye floor, it'll be Karen Bauer, Volpe, Munoz, Herb, Libby, and Gianna Masella to finish things off. Two freshmen and four sophomores in rotation three for the Hawkeyes.
It is very, very impressive when you see this many underclassmen just show off because they have what it takes to elevate the program in future years. And this will just heighten their recruiting process also. They're going to start bringing athletes that just are able to keep up because they're going to set the bar really, really high for future recruits.
Now, you said the score is tied 98-98, and just waiting patiently for Hilton Magic. Now, you know, I'm just a broadcaster. I don't experience it. You've been an athlete here. You saw how, you know, the basketball teams performed here this past year. Then when you were here as a gymnast, is Hilton Magic real in your opinion?
100%. I am a firm believer of the Hilton Magic. It gives you everything you need. It makes you feel at home. And there's no better place to do gymnastics than Hilton.
So here's Hannah Loyam. Start things off on the beam here for the Cyclones. Loyam tied a career high earlier this year, BYU. With a 9.875.
I will say, this is the event where things get really tricky.
Get dicey. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Loyam, an all-around gymnast. She will be performing on the floor as well. So far tonight, a 9.7 in the bars and a 9.75 in the vault. Just the margin for error on the beam, especially with all that's on the line in tonight's meet.
It's just everything.
It's very tricky.
Mm-hmm. Like, again, I don't know if it's in the air, if it's just me. Senior night is very, very different. It hits different.
Yeah, take us back to your senior night. You said you didn't cry. You cried 2 weeks later, but you performed on the floor, the last routine. And, it obviously wasn't that long ago. Take us through your senior night.
You know, I never did pressure events like beam, which, by the way, very, very good routine until her little mishap there and her dismount, but very, very clean, very pretty. But anyway, it was a very emotional meet, but I just can't get myself to cry on pressure settings.
You had to wait till the next term.
Yeah. but it was very special, a night to remember for sure.
And now on to the momentum. Here's the floor routine for Iowa, rotation three. Elise Karenbauer. Now for you, an expert on the floor, what makes a energetic, exciting, and then a well-scored floor routine?
Well, it's a mix of the dance and, it's a mix of performance and skill sets. So, we can see here, Karenbauer has really, really strong dance and very sharp lines. So on her first pass, she did a double back, which, again, that lunge backwards does not give you any deductions. As long as it's controlled and it goes in the direction you are flying into, then perfectly fine. if she were to step forward, then that would have been a deduction. But yeah, that's what makes a floor routine a good score. Just the passes that you do, the combinations you have, the leap series are very important. And just showing off for the judges. This is your time to shine. And for the people who really enjoy the floor event, this is the place to do it.
Spoken like a true All-American.
Oh my gosh, how I miss it.
Alex Cohen, Andrea Maldonado. Here's Elise Karen Bauer capping off her floor routine.
Yeah, that double pike was very, very well landed. That's going to be a really good icebreaker for the Hawkeyes on this event.
So Hannah Loyam, her score on the beam, a 9.675. She gets penalized for her landing, as you said. Just a small mishap. Now the next beam, it'll be Lauren Obrachta, fresh in from Lamont, Illinois. Her career high came last week at NC State, a really impressive 9.875.
Lauren is specialized in this event, and we can see why. I'm going to note this down right here. She could have had the hardest fall of the year with that foot coming off of the beam a little bit on the sidelines right there. It was like a little bit off, but she managed to stay on the beam and finish her triple series, which, by the way, is going to give her, I think, a tenth of bonus. So it makes her routine that much more concise and simple.
Compact.
For the rest of her skill sets. She doesn't have to worry about a lot of stuff, but just finishing her leaps and sticking her landing.
Really starting to come into her own as an Iowa State gymnast. Again, a career high in the beam just last week. That's a nice finish.
Like I said, sticking her dismounts and just managing to stay on the event for her leaps is going to be the trick to this event.
Do you remember your first Cy-Hawk meet?
Oh, yeah. I was a very aggressive athlete, so I was like, let's go, and
ready.
Like, just head on. I don't know.
No nerves?
A lot of nerves,
okay.
Actually.
Fair enough.
But it was very exciting.
There's Eva Volpe. Career high on February 16th, her average floor score this year, just around a 9.7.
I have been very impressed by this athlete right here. She's shown a lot of power tonight. And I'm just like, man, a little bit flabbergasted by how much she brings to the table.
Right, Elise Karen Bauer in the floor, a 9.85, and you're starting to sense the momentum trending towards the Iowa Hawkeyes right now. Have their a nice vault routine. Now getting into the floor, and their first score is a 9.85. And Eva Volpe, an explosive second gymnast here on the floor.
And again, the Hawkeyes are able to build on their momentum because they are faced with a very explosive event. Once they go from vault to the beam, it's gonna have, you know, they're gonna have to tone it down to be able to manage, you know, this much power.
The energy. Mm-hmm. Yeah, the energy is different from a floor routine than the beam. Beam requires a certain amount of being precise that if you do have too much energy, there could be a deduction. There could be a small mishap.
That's right. But Volpe has not failed the Hawkeye team tonight. She is 100% very confident, very pretty. Look at this double back right here. Double pike, very beautiful. That good lunge. Just a little bit of shake of confidence there.
So how about this? Volpe, a 9.85 on the bars, a 9.825 on the vault, likely in the 9.8s here for the floor. Mm-hmm. She'll be an all-around gymnast because she's also right now tentatively scheduled to be a participant in the beam.
Going on to Rachel. Rachel is stunning in this event. She used to be a specialized athlete for the floor event. But once they put her on the beam, she has excelled to just lock in the beam lineup. She has that middle position, which can be very stressful. I think being third in a lineup has a lot to give and a lot to take away. But she manages this pressure so well. I hope to see her more in future seasons. Getting ready for her dismount here. Stuck landing for Rachel. That is exactly what they want. Because if they're able to build momentum on the beam, they're going to come blaring into the floor.
Yep. Rachel Wilk, the junior from Rochester, New York, a 9-8 NC State last week. Might be right around there here tonight. Lauren Obrachta, a 9-7-7-5. And Eva Volpe's score, a 9-7-7-5 as well. Here's Karina Munoz.
I will mention for Karina, I think she has Puerto Rican blood in her because this is like a second national anthem from Puerto Rico. The song is by Mark Anthony, and it's named Preciosa. It's all about the island. So I think that's why she has so much of a fierce look to her. I mean, it wouldn't surprise me if she was a sassy Puerto Rican.
Now, you were from Bayamón, Puerto Rico. You are from Wheel. What was, you know, when you participated in the floor, were you going by some Puerto Rican music, or were you changing it up? You know, what was your music for your floor routine?
I had a very Latina music.
Okay.
Uh-huh. So not like her. She has some reggaeton in there. She has some, like, classics.
That wasn't you.
No. No, I kept it more on the I kept it more on the, like, samba and just general Latin music.
Okay.
She has a lot more. Like, I was not that confident to dance like that, though.
She's a sophomore. She's underclassman.
Yeah. I don't know. I came from a different environment. And so, like her, she's just so impressive. She has all sorts of music in here. Bad Bunny, Mark Anthony, amazing floor routine, amazing passes. She will get a really high score in this routine.
I have to update my Spotify. I really do. We do have a score for Rachel Wilk in the beam. It is a season high. It's a 9.85.
That's exactly what they need. Noelle here. Again, I will say this again. I think I've said it every stream I've sat in this chair. Noelle, wow. How confident can she be in this event?
Freshman, yep.
It's very impressive. She has a really good pace, beautiful flexibility to portray and show off. I'm at a jinxster, but she will carry on this routine with a very high level of poise.
It's back on the beam. And at the single highest score for a Cyclone gymnast on the beam this year with a 9.925 that came against Southern Utah 2 weeks ago. Now, obviously, tonight that won't happen, but she still has the floor routine to go.
She also has really pretty lines and really clean skills. So I don't know that there will be a lot of deduction space for her other than her fall.
And you could tell there's some frustration there, just the competitor she is. But once again, the future is bright for Noelle Adams.
That's what I was thinking. I was about to say, like, she's only a freshman. These moments are going to happen. There's a lot of pressure in the air. There's a lot at stake because, you know, the Cy-Hawk series is
it's a big deal.
It's a big deal. So it's okay to be frustrated. I just wish for her in the future that she's able to just shake it off.
Come back.
Keep going.
Smile on her face. Mm-hmm. Karina Munoz on her floor routine. You said you were expecting a high score. You got it. A 9.875.
Really good score for her.
Here's Emily Erb. Now with a completely different set of music.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's the beauty about college gymnastics. You see so much variety in this event, especially in this event. You see a lot of personalities come through, and a lot of skills just flying around. Like this double pike for an opener is just very impressive when athletes are able to do such powerful passes at the very beginning of their routines.
Now you hit the nail on the head. Powerful, ferocious. It's an intense routine right now. Intense music, intense movements.
And that, you know, that goes to show that some athletes like this kind of, it's almost like a noise blocker. You're able to zone in more. Just like athletes that like to breathe a little bit more and have slower pace music and choreographies. These also help you to like hype yourself up for the end of your routine.
Here's Emily Earp.
Beautiful. Such a good pass and connection for her. You know, that 1.5 to a front full will give her the deduction she needs to not require another set of leaps in her routine or a double back in her dismount.
So Noelle Adams, her score was a 9.225, and now the margin for error on the beam for Josie Bergstrom and Lauren Thomas just got a little bit more difficult. Now, if you're Iowa State here and you're going into rotation four, how close do you need to be, not to feel comfortable, but to really feel like you're in the thick of things? How many points, like, do you have to be even, or you know, what's the margin of, I guess, not defeat through the first three rotations, but where do you have to be to feel confident that you could come back and make up the score in the floor routine?
They 100% want to score over 49 total, so it's going to be up to the last few routines to make up for that middle space to be able to put them there in that situation where they have at least 0.2 worth of an advantage, or at least to just be able to score 299s on floor and take the lead.
Here's Josie Bergstrom. This year she's been very consistent on the beam, a season high 9.875 at NC State last week.
And she delivers. She delivers, just like I was saying. They're going to need that 9.85 or 9.8 to be able to just match up and make up for that fall.
No, I think that's a perfect point. If you see the scores here on the beam for Iowa State, a 9.675, 9.775, a 9.85. You have the 9.225 from Noelle. And now with Josie Bergstrom and Lauren Thomas, you probably need an average at around a 9.8 or a 9.825 to really feel comfortable going into rotation floor in your floor routine.
That's right. First front pass we see here. Sorry that I cut you off
No, you're good.
But yeah, I'm always very impressed when I see athletes tumble forward. It shows a lot of skill. It shows a lot of determination and power because not everybody is skilled enough to just go forward and twist or flip like that.
Emily Earp, her score on the floor was a 9.85. Here's Bailey Libby. Last two gymnasts on the floor for Iowa will be Libby and Gianna Masella.
And another halfway front pass here for her. She had a really good lunge forward. And so far, just enjoying the pace of this routine. You can tell this routine is, unlike the other ones, a lot more paused. She has a more steady pace, an artistic feel to it.
Seems a little bit more poetic.
Mm-hmm.
And you could tell there is a certain amount of precision to this routine for Bailey Libby. Josie Bergstrom, we were talking about her score, needed to be in the 9.8s, a 9.875, tying her season high. Cyclones needed a big routine from Josie Bergstrom, the junior. She gave it to them.
That's right. That's like I said, she delivered. And again, Libby and the rest of the Hawkeye lineup is going to bring on the pressure. You cannot rely on the other team making a mistake. You have to make sure that you are one step ahead of them.
Now you have Lauren Thomas. We talked about these last two gymnasts needing to average somewhere in the 9.8-2.5-9.8 range. If you can get a 9.775 from Lauren Thomas, you're in a good position going into rotation four. This is very important routine for the Cyclones.
That's right. Let's just sit back and enjoy this routine and see what the Cyclones bring to the table.
Career high 9.9 came earlier this year against Illinois State. Wow.
You can see there how she was a little bit sideways and still managed to stay on the event and hone herself in.
We saw her warming up right in front of us before this beam routine.
Getting ready for her last few skills. Again, last beam routine at Hilton. This is going to be the make it or break it. So far, all she has left is her dismount.
How will she finish?
Round off 1.5. Do a really, really good landing. That little bit of a step is going to probably be a 1/10 deduction, but again, a really clean and poised routine.
We have one more left here for Iowa on the floor. It's Gianna Masella. Again, the lowest score here for Iowa on the floor, a 9.775 by Eva Volpe. So if Gianna Masella get above a 9.8, that'll increase the team's score. It's going to be mighty close going into rotation 4.
That's right. This is where the competition gets. You were asking earlier, where does the competition get, like, tricky? And this is about it.
Is it?
Yeah. 100%, like, when Logan was going, that's when you start to feel the pressure going into rotation 3. But after rotation 3, you see where the teams land, and that's where things just get really fast-paced, and everybody, you know, the pressure heightens a lot more.
Well, the pressure is pretty palpable right now.
I'll say that. Oh, yeah. I feel it in my chest.
All right, so we have a score on the beam for Lauren Thomas. That's a 9.825, the last two gymnasts on the beam for the Cyclones, delivering a huge way, averaging a 9.85 between the two.
I will say, Masella had a little bit of a step forward in her front on her first pass, which was directed backwards. So that will be a deduction that will count towards this final score. So far, she is having just a shortage of rotation in all of her passes. So she's having to make up for it, essentially. But you can see here the unofficial score for both teams. They're 2/10 away from each other, Iowa taking the lead here. So it's going to be up to the Cyclones.
On the floor. I mean, it puts them within 2/10 of a point. Iowa at 49.2, Iowa State at 49. And, yeah, I can't even begin to tell you how big those last two beam routines by Josie Bergstrom and Lauren Thomas were for the Cyclones. When you go 9.875, 9.825 to combine with Rachel Wilk with a 9.85, that's a pretty impressive beam for Iowa State. To this competition, their highest, a 49.325. That was against North Carolina State, or last week at North Carolina State. That was their highest score on the beam in any event since 2017. Well, they get a 49 tonight.
That's right. And you can also see Logan exhibitioning here. And this could potentially be a high score routine for them in the future, in the postseason. So I think they are starting to come together with their scores.
I mean, that's what Ashley Greek said to us earlier.
Yep, that's true. It's all about how well they are going to put out for the rest of the competitions they have this season.
All right, it's getting fun here at Hilton Coliseum. We are going to take a break. When we come back, it's rotation 4. Iowa State close in the Cyhawk meet right now, Big 12 Now.
My experience has been short here. I'm really grateful to get the chance the past 2 years to have a different opportunity for gymnastics. Being a Cyclone has been one of the greatest experiences of my life. I've learned a lot about myself as a leader. I've learned just a lot about myself in general. And it's been cool to see myself grow as a gymnast and as a person the whole time I've been here.
6 years ago, I would never thought that I would be here. Coming from another country, like coming to Iowa State and finding a family, been like the most meaningful part of like coming here. They've been there for me, like in my bad days, in my good days, and I would really be grateful like my whole life for it. The thing that I will remember the most is going to be like the hard days, the days that we're putting the work, and then you come back and realize that those are paying off, that maybe all the sweat, all the tears, all the pain, the soreness, it's paying off and it's worth it. I think that's the most meaningful part of being here.
I'm thankful for the different chapters that I've had. I think every year has brought something new, and I think every year I've kind of learned from that experience. I'm very thankful for the new coaching staff, and I'm overall just very grateful for the girls coming in, like not knowing anyone, and having like a whole team of girls to just pick you up, be by your side. It's just something that I'm very grateful for. I think the memory that stands out the most to me is first meet back after an injury. I will never forget how happy I was, how excited I was, how excited my team was for me, and just how grateful I was in that moment to be doing what I loved.
I obviously am from Canada. 4 years ago when I committed here, like, I thought Iowa and Idaho were the same thing. I was just up and moving. It's been a really good experience. I have made a family here, and it's been really nice having my family so far away, creating a whole nother family here. And we have a lot of fun together. We cry a lot, laugh a lot. We treat each other like sisters, like the coaches. They love us like our parents do. And they care for us like our parents do. They care not just about what we do in the gym, but also our outside life. They make sure we're doing okay. They make sure we're eating, sleeping, all the things that a family would do. I have a lot of love for this program. I'm really grateful for everything it's given me, the experiences, the people, all the learning opportunities. I think there was a lot here. I'm very grateful for the experience.
It's definitely been a roller coaster. I know that's pretty cliche to say, but I've been here for a while, and every year's been a different team. I think this team has grown in terms of like camaraderie and support, and I know I've grown a lot too. As a bar specialist, I think I've been really proud of the first time I got a 9.9. I was just a sophomore at the time, and I struggled a lot with confidence as a sophomore because I was just an event specialist. It really proved that I'm really deserving of being in a spot and lineup and, you know, proving to everyone else that I can be as good as I think I can be.
Back here on Big 12 Now on ESPN Plus, it is a tight Cy-Hawk meet as we go to rotation four. Alex Cohen, Andrea Maldonado here on the call. Before we start rotation four, we would love to thank our Cyclones.tv crew here in Ames. It's their effort that makes watching gymnastics from Hilton Coliseum on ESPN Plus possible. A huge thank you to the people whose names that you see on the screen. It's a lot of people, well deserved. I do not deserve to be on there. Everybody else does. Jared Calvert, especially at the bottom. You do a tremendous job directing us. Thank you all you guys for all the effort that you put in and, you know, making this presentation among the best in the entire Big 12. It's really impressive. All right, so we have rotation four coming up, and the Iowa State seniors, it'll be the Iowa seniors that are being honored tonight. We have five of them. Saw Aubrey Nick earlier tonight. The other four not participating in events here during the Cy-Hawk meet. You have Ella Castellanos, a transfer from Long Island. Madeline Kenlin, 2022 NCAA beam runner-up. Kendall LaPlante, two-time academic All-Big Ten. Getting to the beam, it's Eva Volpe. Start things off again. 0.2 of a point, the difference going into rotation four. 147.2 to 147. We were talking about it in the break. Andrea Maldonado was taking us back to when she performed in the Cy-Hawk meet. Yeah, she was shaking then, she's shaking now.
Yeah, I mean, it's just now this is time for showing off for both teams. You know, like I was mentioning before, beam is going to be a pressure event for the Hawkeyes, and floor is going to be a show-off event for the Cyclones. However, it needs to be controlled on both events, because if one mistake goes wrong, either team could take the lead any second now.
Yeah, the Cyclones at this point have to show for dough. They show, they win.
That's true. And Eva is right here just standing on the line there. She had a little bit of a mistake on her front aerial right there, but getting ready to finish her routine. She's gonna have a round off, 1.5 tucked in with a, again, I think she scored, I mean, stuck all her landings tonight. I believe she scored 4 for 4.
So here is Madeline Matternack. sophomore from Stevens Point, Wisconsin. Career high last week. North Carolina State, a 9-9. If she could do that here tonight, look out.
To start off with a 9-9 would be to win this competition. She excels in this event, though. You'll see how explosive and sharp she is in everything she does. Starting with a double tuck, a little bit of a step there. Again, like I mentioned before, they cannot get ahead of themselves because the landings are going to betray them. They have to make sure to lunge backwards or in whatever direction they're going and stay in bounds.
So how do you, you know, maintain your composure when you get into a high energy type of floor routine? You take a deep breath before? Is it something that you do during your routine? How would you maintain your composure throughout your floor routine?
Breathe and pray. That's what I would say.
There you go. Fair enough.
That's what I would do at least. It's just down to the details. And also, it takes a lot of experience to manage that. Mananak is only making her debut this year as a sophomore. She didn't have the opportunity to compete last year. So this year, she's starting with the Cyclones as technically a freshman. So she's growing that energy, growing that consistency and confidence. So you're going to see some mishaps here and there, but she's going to get better in getting the hang of that pressure.
She debuts on the floor here at the Cyhawk meet. We have a score on the beam for Iowa. Eva Volpe with a 9.775. So that's a good start for Iowa on the beam. You're in rotation four.
I would dare to say that Mananak is going to score a 9.7. She had a little bit of a just like questionable landings there that are just going to take those tenths away.
Here's Alexa Ebeling.
I believe this is the first time we see Alexa tonight. She had a little bit of a balance check there.
Again, the margin for error for Iowa here.
Very limited.
Yeah, the beam is just so precise. Two small mishaps by two different competitors, and you're looking at an Iowa State victory in the Cyhawk meet.
And then there you see how the pressure is starting to take over. She had a connection to make there that's going to be detrimental to her start value of her routine. So she has to be smart and make up for that connection in the rest of her leaps and routine. So it's going to be a matter of intuitiveness how she can make up for this mistake. So far, so good. I think she had a really good routine, but it's going to be up to the judges to just make sure that she gets evaluated for that connection properly.
That was a pretty good dismount there as a recovery.
Yeah.
Still waiting for the score for Madeline Mananak. Rachel Wilk will be the second gymnast on the floor for the Cyclones. Wilk, 9.85. She's done it three times overall, twice this year. And Wilk with a 9.85 in the beam. Let's see if she can continue that momentum from a really good performance earlier tonight.
Rachel was taken out of the floor lineup for a little bit last year to save her ankles. But this year, she's gotten way stronger and way better on her skill sets. And her ankles have no issues whatsoever. You can see her enjoying this routine.
There's a certain energy with her tonight.
Yeah, she's very confident. And again, it just makes me very proud. She was a freshman when I was a senior, so seeing her grow this far is just, it even makes me emotional. She's one of those people that is a very, very genuine person for sure. A lot of love to give to the world and she's very passionate about this sport, so. Very, very happy for Rachel.
Well, the fruits of her labor are really taking shape here tonight.
Double pike. Make sure to stay in bounds, and she does it.
That's pretty good.
She has a very, very hyped up routine. She's able to engage with her teams, the crowd, and again, just very powerful.
That's pretty good. So we have a score for Madeline Matternack, a 9-4-2-5.
It's a little bit of a drop there. I think that score doesn't necessarily reflect her work, but again, we're getting towards that time of the night where things have to get very detailed, and we have to get all the those just like teeny tiny things.
And it's rotation forward. Yeah. It's important. Marissa Rojas here on the beam for Iowa. So Iowa's two scores, 9-7-7-5. Eva Volpe and Alexa Ebeling with a 9-5-7-5. So we're waiting for Rachel Wilkes' score.
Triple series right there for Rojas. Very confident, very on top of the beam. Again, you have 4 inches to make mistakes in this event. So to be able to do that, especially a triple series,
wow,
in your last event is very memorable.
4 inches to make a mistake. Well, when you put it that way, good luck.
You don't have much margin
no,
of error.
No, not.
And she sticks that landing for the Hawkeyes. Man, I cannot wait for how close this is going to be.
That's a really nice routine for Marissa Rojas. Low center of gravity, stuck the landing. We are waiting for Rachel Wilkes' score.
I believe it was a 9-8. They're flagging it up there.
Well, that's a 9-8. That's a good start.
Yeah.
Now we have Laura Cook, senior. Big routine for her.
Yes, and it's also a fan favorite, because guess what? I say it every time. Welcome, everybody. Juicy wiggle for you.
Get the fans up and hyped up. You were right about Rachel Wolk, a 9-8. Here we go.
Oh, yeah. I believe this is the magic song we play in every game.
Your belief is a correct one. What makes Hilton Coliseum so special, or one of the many reasons.
Front double full to a very beautiful lunge. Here we go.
You could just feel the energy.
It is crazy in here. To whoever wants to not miss a gymnastics meet ever again, please do come next year.
Just a ringing endorsement from Andrea Maldonado.
She has a two-pass routine. So she's about to do her dismount here, which is going to be a round-off 1.5 punch front full. She also makes up for a bonus with that full turn, which is going to be very, very important at the end of her routine for in terms of scoring.
We saw Ashley Gree before this floor routine. She was amped. That's a really nice finish. Energy here from Laura Cook.
We see here, she did a 1.5 to front layout instead of a full. I think they went a little bit conservative on her last pass. Maybe on practice, she was starting to get a little bit too excited. Oh my gosh, I see tears. But yes, that was a way to be conservative for this routine.
Senior on her last floor routine. A lot of tears here tonight. Marissa Rojas on the beam, a 9-8-2-5. So here's Aubrey Nick. I have to say, Iowa on the beam here in rotation four. Two scores of a 9-7-7-5 and a 9-8-2-5. That puts the pressure on Iowa State.
100%. It's going to be up to, we have Loyam, Parker, and Adams coming up. I think we still have a lot of space.
Oh, it's still close.
Like, it's going to get close, but I think they have a lot of space to either make it or break it right now.
Still waiting on Laura Cook's score.
A stuck landing for the Hawkeyes, and my heart is racing out of my mouth. Look at that beautiful 1.5. Just so close together. Her legs were just right there on the landing.
Laura Cook in her last floor routine at Hilton Coliseum here for the Cy Hawk meet, a 9-7-7-5. You have a 9-8, a 9-7-7-5, a 9-4-2-5, and here's Hannah Loyum. Loyum, her season high is a 9-8-7-5, but her career best was in the last Cy-Hawk meet here at Hilton Coliseum in 2022. You were a part of that.
Oh, yeah.
A 9-9-2-5. Can she do that here tonight?
I am going to put all my faith in this kid. Right now, she has an entry of a double layout. It's the lone double layout tonight, and it'll come down to this pass. And she does it! She does it! There you can see that just really well, kind of like hidden lunge that was in place. She didn't took it forward or backwards, so that will be up to the judge. 1.5 to front layout. Very, very controlled. This is the end of her routine. Now she gets to have fun.
Now here comes the energy. I think this will be my floor routine song. I love it. Could you imagine?
This was a song of former Olympian Ariana Orego, which was also a Cyclone. We used to play this song almost every day for
Ari. I have great taste.
We used to play this song almost every day. It was amazing.
Aubrey Nicker's score on the beam was a 9-8-5. So where does Hannah Loyum go from here?
I was going to say, before Hannah went on and Nick got her score, we are 0.02 away. That's the difference that the Cyclones have from the Hawkeyes. It's just a very, very small difference. Really just going to come down to those very last.
Well, it's going to come routines. Down to the last two routines here on the beam for Iowa. It's Ilka Juk and Karina Munoz. And when you have three top scorers and Alexa Ebeling with a 9-5-7-5, if you're Iowa, you get conservative here on the beam here in rotation four to try to keep this close.
That's right. And you can see Juk here just going all out. She had a triple series. I believe she has a very unique skill in the middle of her routine, which is going to count for her acro requirements. And again, she's a very beautiful athlete. She has a lot of flexibility to show off. And you can definitely see she's very confident in this
event.
Yeah,
some poise there.
Yeah.
Controlled movements on the beam, which is really difficult to maintain, especially here at this point of the meet.
I think this is where her unique skill comes in. Watch this. Crazy! That is very beautiful. I think that probably the most impressive thing I've seen all night.
And this beam routine for Iowa in rotation four has been impressive to say the least.
Mm-hmm. Judges are gonna like that. Almost stuck that landing, but she's got it. She's got the routine in the bag. It's probably 9-8, I would dare to say, as a low one.
Well, she goes 9-8 there. Hannah Loyum with a 9-8 for
even.
Iowa State. 9-8 even. So Wilk with a 9-8, Loyum with a 9-8, Cook with a 9-7-7-5. So here's Kaia Parker. We were talking about it in the open. A 9-9-2-5 at NC State. Senior studying event management. And this is a big one for her.
Kaia has everything she needs to score a 10. I believe in the interview with Coach Greek, she was talking about this. So let's see if it happens for Kaia in the near future.
Look at that height.
Oh my God, this is so exciting because she's grown so confident of this routine. Oh my gosh, I can remember her
as
a freshman.
You saw it early on.
Yeah, I can remember her as a freshman. It was, just like the level she's grown is impressive. 360 difference.
Allison Juk with a 9-9. This will be Ilka Juk with a 9-9.
Let's see what Kaia can score right now.
It needs to be somewhere in the...
This double pike needs to be perfect.
Yep.
The tension.
It's palpable.
Oh my gosh. You can hear the crowd just roaring and waiting. It's like, please.
Give me one. Here we go.
Round up, backhand spring, double pike. Wow. To a perfect, absolutely perfect landing. Please, judges, for the love of God, give her what she deserves.
I think she deserves a high score after that. The senior comes up big.
Wow. Wow, wow. Look at that beautiful double pike.
You're a judge. What's your score there?
Oh, man, that was a 10 for me.
Spoken like a true cyclone. Here's Karina Munoz.
Karina, yeah, I was going to say, like, Karina has beautiful legs. Her legs are rarely long. So, like, on her leaps, you can see how long she looks and how extended it is.
Yeah, but it's also so graceful to be that long and have your movements be so minute. It's a fun skill to have.
100%. I was very short and stubby, so I can't say that for myself.
Not going to talk about you, but I felt that description very well, too, so. Okay.
There is a little bit of a bounce check there, and I can see the coaches for Iowa State get a little bit upset there because Kaya got flashed a 9.85 and a 9.9. That's going to be a 9.875 of an average. And Munoz just stuck that landing. She has such a fierce just look to her. Man, very intimidating. I would be very intimidated to be competing against her. Beautiful
so
stuck landing, yeah.
Looking at the scores right now, we're still waiting for Munoz. But Iowa State on the floor, 9.775, 9.8, 9.875, and a 9.8. If you're Noelle Adams here, you need to be somewhere in the 9.875 range, I would guess.
Yeah. This routine needs to be that consistent 9.9. That's what it needs to be.
Well, she has a single highest score on the floor this year with a 9.95.
Starting off with that front layout to front, 1.5. Again, from this very simple perspective, so far so good.
This needs to be vibrant,
yep.
Outrageous.
This needs to be the winner.
Well, Munoz with a 9.9. Last score on the beam. I mean, that is a clutch beam routine for Iowa. 9.999, 9.85, 9.825, and a 9.775.
And I think, I don't know about a 9.9. I mean, man, Kaya did not have any space for deduction, and that was a 9.875. So with a bounce check, I'm almost like wondering if that was all they took. Double tuck. A perfect landing for Adams. Oh my goodness. Let's see where we land here.
She is a special freshman.
100%. That's the confidence we were looking for. I remember in a conversation with Coach Grieg, she was saying that whenever Noelle is not smiling, there's a problem. So I really like to see that smile back on her face. Oh, it looks like there's a pause here.
So we're going to wait for Noelle Adams' score after the floor routine for Iowa State. We're going to take a break here on Big 12 Now on ESPN Plus. When we come back, we'll talk about rotation for scores, and we'll likely have a final result in the Cy-Hawk meet. Iowa, Iowa State coming down to the wire. Take a break right now, Big 12 Now on ESPN Plus. Wrapping things up at the 88th Cy-Hawk meet here from Hilton Coliseum. Alex Cohen, Andrea Maldonado. We have unofficial scores. The Iowa Hawkeyes, after a floor routine of 49.2, a final score of 196.450. And Iowa State with their floor routine of a 49.175, 196.175. less than 0.3 of a point. Andrea Maldonado, these scores are unofficial, but give me some of your thoughts for tonight's matches. Before that, we'll give you our individual winners on the vault. Josie Bergstrom, Emily Hahn, Karina Munoz, first two for Iowa State. Last one for Iowa, a 9.85. Logan Boswell in her last bar routine for Iowa State as a senior. At least here at Hilton Coliseum in a Cyhawk meet, a 9.925 on the beam. Rotation four, Karina Munoz and Ilka Juck with a 9.9. And then that four, we're talking about Noelle Adams, a 9.925 as a freshman. I mean, that was stellar. Andrea Maldonado, you see that 9.925 from Adams, just not enough, obviously, after the beam on rotation four for Iowa. Just your final thoughts tonight.
Yeah, I think a difference of 0.275 speaks volumes of how just good these both of these programs are. I'm very excited to see what they come up with in the postseason. I think they should be very close coming on to regionals and such. So I'm just simply very excited for both the Hawkeyes and the Cyclones to just show off.
All right, one more thing. Talking to Coach Ashley Grieg before, said, you know, you're looking for that new identity, that new energy here with this Iowa State program in her first year, and I think they might have that.
That's right.
Really impressive job, all right, for Andrea Maldonado and Lily Prohaska. I'm Alex Cohen saying so long from Hilton Coliseum for the final time this year with the unofficial final score. Iowa, the Hawkeyes, 196-450, and Iowa State, 196-175. Unofficially, the Cyhawk meet goes to the Hawkeyes. All games airing on the ESPN networks are streaming live and archived on the ESPN app. This has been a presentation.